the pranayama component is the breathing exercises, trying to know how to breathe properly in itself is probably the most important part of it, or even actually asanas are good, keeps you flexible, gives you the energy to sit properly. But the breathing part are even more directly helpful to the functional component that I was talking about, the physiology of your body, the vasovagal tone, stimulation of the parasympathetic system to balance our sympathetic system. It probably even plays a bigger part. So now we'll do pranayama. We start with, so it's actually pran kriya because we are doing the ritual form of it. When we go more subtle, then it's pranayama. So first one being bhastika, so sitting as straight as much as you can, your back being straight, and breathing in and out. So what we do is we breathe through our nostrils, we breathe out through our nostrils. When we breathe in, your belly button goes out. When you breathe out, the belly button pushes in. So you're breathing in, belly button goes out. When you breathe out, belly button is pushed in. Okay, so try again. Now the variation of it's called Sudarshan Kriya. So it's same thing. When you lift your hands up, breathe in. When you are lifting, bring your hands down, push your belly button in and breathe out. So again, bhastika pranayama. If it's so, the body is not still, then you can just support yourself by pushing your hands from the back and doing the same thing. One more time. When you practice, you know, it's actually even more harder than just doing the asana, because the amount of muscles that get pushed in your chest, in your tummy, on your side, on your back, on your shoulders, behind your neck, they actually are really difficult to do because it requires that amount of focus to breathe properly. And if you do through your nostrils, you'll never feel dizzy or anything. Carbon dioxide accumulation doesn't happen. Yeah, you are not really hyperventilating, but actually you are properly breathing in and properly breathing out. So proper oxygenation is happening. So there are different mudras that we utilize, and they're helpful in different ways in whatever pranayam we do. Okay. So that was Bhastika. Now let's do what's called Agnisar. So we breathe in deeply, breathe out every bit of air if you can. Push the belly button in and then out while you are holding the breath. One more time, breathe deeply, breathe out all, and then while we're holding the breath, we'll move our belly button in and out. So it increases your capacity to actually hold your breath and gives the exercise onto the Nabhi chakra. In the beginning, you might be able to do 5 times. If you keep practicing, it becomes 10, 15, 20, and your holding of your breath increases actually. One more time, breathe in, breathe out. Just notice that we always breathe through our nostrils. The nostrils are given for breathing, eating, and things are for the mouth. Yeah. Now we'll do what's called Vahi Kriya. So we are breathing through our throat, again using nostrils, but the focus will be on the throat. You feel the vibrations. Obviously, it's very helpful for your glands, parathyroid, etc., thymus, immune system, helps you speak, another thing. So these are touching different chakras that I talked about earlier. So now put your chin onto the chest and do the same breathing in while your chin is on the throat. When you fill your lung, then bring your neck up, close your right nostril and breathe out through the left. Huh? So Ujjayi Pranayam, we did Bhastika, then we did Sudarshan Kriya, then we did Agnisar. Now what we did was Ujjayi Pranayam. So obviously very good for immune system development, your throat, speaking ability, speech, control of your speech. Basically, it gives you time to think before what you say. So that's called Ujjayi Pranayam. Now we'll do Kapalbhati. Kapalbhati is the pranayam that we do for the, this is mainly exhalation. It's not inhalation. Are we still going on? Yes. So inhalation, other pranayams were inhalation and exhalation. This is actually exhalation. So we breathe out while we push our belly button in. So it's a bit like this. So do it at your own pace. Don't have to race with anyone. Yeah. So in each of these pranayama, we try and keep our back straight as much as we can. If you need support like this, you can use it. You can sit on the chair, whatever helps you. If you can just be straight. Now, you push belly button in as you breathe out. So you're focusing on exhalation only, and vacuum, which is created automatically, inspiration happens. So don't worry that you will stop breathing. It just is, the focus is on exhalation, and kapal means your, the fontanelle metaphorically being open, each of your channel pathway, energy centers are being stimulated. It's very powerful. So let's do kapal bhati. And we do, like every week, we do for a while amount of time. When we start sweating, then we stop, yeah? So if you feel pain, then you can stop, but then you can start again later. It's painful in terms of it pulls your muscles a lot. But as you keep, once you learn the art of doing it, it becomes rhythmic. And then slowly over time, you incorporate different mantras to further help your different energy centers of your body. That's how the Kapalbhati works. Now we'll do what's called Vaikumbhak. So with that, we breathe in, which is called Abhyantara Vritti, deep breath in. Deep breath out. Vai Vritti. And then when you hold it, it's Vaikumbhak. Put your chin on your chest. Mulban, Jalandan Ban, Udan Ban. So all your faces are closed. You're holding your breath. When you can't breathe, you can't hold. So breathe in slowly. As you breathe in, feel the presence of this vibrations. Yeah, the energy always are around. These energies are always around us. Sometimes we feel it when we call Vai. So once you have, you know, they say when people who have high amounts of Vai, their tribe becomes smaller because you then live with everyone, everywhere, all the time. You don't have to be physically attached to people, because otherwise that's the only way otherwise you know how to relate. So these exercises actually develops that potential, the sixth sense of you to connect to the energy, because as I said, electromagnetic frequency, this energy within the body is the same energy that is outside as well. So if we can connect to it, life becomes much, much more easier. You're always happy, you're always energetic, you're healthy. It's not actually some mystical thing. Hindu religion in many ways actually is very scientific. It works through your body, your components, the antennas or the senses of this, and relates to the universe. And every different forms of Hindu prayers is just a small or a different stage for different levels of society to relate to this energy. That's all it's trying to do. So as you keep understanding and growing in it, you will come to one state that the temple, that all the prayers, all the yajnas become inside, and you are then directly connected. So it's actually a very beautiful, our rishis and sages who understood this and helped in some way let the generations know to us now is a huge help. Unfortunately, the world is still not aware of it. So we do again Abhyantara Vritti, Vai Vritti, Vai Kumbhak. So your mind itself, without me telling you, through this phase, is already removed about, you know, I keep saying about 60,000-70,000 thoughts come in a day. That is what exhausts you, drains you, your body becomes ultimately sick, you know, tired, you can't manage. Now, this simple exercises actually removes this extra amount of monkey mind that is there. So you're getting minimal now disturbance. You're not controlling your mind. You're not doing anything to hold things coming in you. But you yourself become within yourself. Talking is easy. Doing is what will actually make you achieve this thing. Breathe one more time.
Vaikumbha. Within, Vaibriti. Hold it. Chin on your chest. So that's Vai Kumbhak. Now we'll do Anulom Vilom, which is alternate nasal breathing. So with Anulom Vilom, so use the fingers as I teach you every week. You can use the mudra, then use this two to support yourself. Ring finger on your left nostril, thumb on your right. Breathe in through the left, and then hold it, then breathe out to the right, then hold it, breathe in to the right, breathe in to the left. Breathe out to the left. So let's do it. Into the left, out to the right. Into the right. Out to the left, in through the left, out to the right, in through the right, out to the left, in through the left, out to the right, in through the right, out to the left, in through the left. Out to the right, in through the right, out to the left, in through the left, out to the right, in through the right, out to the left. Now, that was Anulom Vilom. Nadi Shodhan is the same movement, but it's just very subtle now. So like each of the Vedic mantras are interpreted in a three different level. So each of these exercises also have different planes of how it's utilized. Initially, just mechanical, ritual. Secondly, you are involving your mind, being mindful. Then third component is we become subtle. Your Karan Sharir is then involved. Now with Nadi Shodhan, as you breathe in, it's so subtle you can't even hear yourself. But same routine. Through your left. Hold it. Out to the right. Into the right. Out to the left. In through the left, hold, out to the right, out to the right, into the right, hold, out to the left. In through the left, hold, out to the right, into the right, hold. Out to the right, out to the left. So that's Nadi Shodhan. Nadi, the 72,000 channeling, subtle systems apart from your artery, veins, nerves, there are other components, your belly button to your mother, mother being the femininity of the creation. That's why there's always a feminine side which is described. of the whole Hiranyagarbha, the creation itself, that is the womb. So your connection to the universe. Now at this level, you are completely at peace with yourself. Your mind is now, no matter, you know, all other things that you do, you can't actually become so happy in your own self. The other things are very temporary. So when you reach this state, then only you can meditate. Meditation is very difficult. A lot of people say they meditate, or people, you know, run businesses and well and good. They try and help people. But most of the people who teach meditation even truly are not meditating themselves. It's not that easy. We are doing what most people do is what's called concentration, dharana. Dharana leads to dhyana. Dhyana is meditation, and dhyana, in phase of dhyana, you become blissful and you have samadhi. And that's all everyone is looking for. That's why the whole world is so unhappy. In a very lowest level, they kill each other. Other human beings, no respect for anybody, forget about plants and animals, but not for humans even. In other level, then you are trickery, the corporate mafia, the pharma mafia, and other things. You don't have to really don't think of people, but the profit for you is everything. So different forms of the same thing that happen. Greed of either ego controls or the greed controls, or then the attachments of things, which is really making people more frustrated. And that's why the state of such a high advanced technologically, the world that we are living in today is so unhappy. We all know. People in villages were much more happier. It's hard to accept it, but that's the truth. Because they were related to the nature, the environment. They were not hoarders. They didn't want 150 houses or everything. They knew the life was finite. We think we will live forever. So this state is a state of then allowing you to now take advantage of yourself to actually go even deeper. Feel yourself. So the physical component we covered by asanas, the exercises, the mind, the emotion by breathing exercises, expressing our vasovagal tone. Now, which it leads to, and that's why I do these things in this manner, so that you really can reach the state of actually enjoying the science of yoga. What Hinduism teaches is learning about who you are, why we are here, what is this purpose of human life. So this moment now gives you that opportunity to actually be intuitive. So let's do some meditation and we finish it off thereafter. So the three components of Om are is coming out at the level of your Nabhi Chakra, the belly button area. U, Vishuddhi, your throat. Sahasra, on your top. So your entire body is connecting to that sound of the universe. That's why utilize Om, the primordial sound. So initially it's Vachik, you are loudly saying. Then it's Upamsik, becomes more mild, subtle. And then thirdly, as you go up to the level of the mind and your connection with total connection, it's just Mansik within yourself. Try one more time, Utki. Om Bhurvasvah Tat Savitur Varenyam Bhargo Devasya Dhimahi Diyo Yo Na Prachodayat. Ye Parampita Paramatma, hum apne vibindu ko nirvati ke liye aur aapke poorn anand ki prapti ke liye apne poorn shakti se aapke sharan mein aaye hain. आप कृपया करके हमारे संपूर्ण दुखों को दूर करके हमें पूर्ण आनंद की प्राप्ति कराइए और आपकी कृपा हमारे ऊपर सदा बनी रहे. गोट गिव ऑफ लाइफ रिमूव ऑफ पेन सोरोस बिस्ट ऑफ हैप्पीनेस क्रिएटर ऑफ यूनिवर्स द मोस्ट ल्यूमिनस प्योर एंड अडोरेबल वी मेडिटेट ऑन दी प्लीज इंस्पायर एंड गाइड अवर इंटेलेक्ट इन द राइट डायरेक्शन. Pratihara is interoception, looking inside, identifying yourself after the 1.5 hours of exercise that we did, is who you really are beyond this body, mind, emotion. Identify yourself. There's only two forms of things, which is chetan, beyond. There's no form, no shape or structure. Paramatma, the eternal energy, unlimited energy, or the limited form of it, called the Atma, or the soul or spirit, people call the energy center. This is limited. It is attached to a body according to the justice or karmic system of the creation itself. It travels through different forms and humans in different levels of their accumulation of what's called impressions, so sanskars from many lifetimes. Because that justice system of the universe, as you can understand, it can't be a man-made court system where it can be corrupted or can be, there can be injustice. It has to be completely fair. Otherwise, the speed of earth that spins, earth won't spin like this, or the speed of sun itself, or the our Milky Way in the cosmos, as I said, about 2 million kilometers per second. So there is a complete justice system. So this limited form of consciousness is in every living form. It's called Chetna. So there's only two types of things. That's one, unlimited, so Atma being Alpach, Paramatma being beyond every control, everything. But this is limited, that's why within our senses, the apparatus, our system that is, it gets covered in dust. So identify first, the first phase of it is to know who you are. So remind yourself, Main Shuddhi Atma Hu, Main Chetan Swarup Hu, Main Shuddhi Atma, Main Chetan Swarup Hu. Main na paanch tan matra hai, paanch mahabhut das indriya, chitta man ahankara buddhi. I'm not this body, I'm not even this mind. I'm not the five primordial elements which make this body, or the five subtle elements that run this body, or the mind, or the memories, or the ego, or the intelligence. But I'm the divine. I'm the part and parcel of that eternal consciousness, that energy. Identifying yourself, interoception, pratihara is probably the most important
component of this path. Mashuddhi Atma, Chetan Sarupa, Mashuddhi Atma, Chetan Sarupa. So doing that brings you to a state of concentration, dharana. So in that dharana, you need to be intelligent. Now use your intelligence to actually focus on something really, really beyond anything and everything which is most powerful. You can do it for small things, for small gains. And that's why doing these exercises are actually very helpful even for your material living. So if you focus this every morning, which people like Elon Musk and Einstein and them used to do, they were in solitude, they sat alone and acquired this universal energy to drive them towards technological science and technology advancements. So you can do that. It's helpful at that level. So you can choose what you want to do. But ultimately, if you really want liberation of the cycle that I was talking about, the justice of being born 9 months in the womb, go through primary school, get beaten by everyone, gossiping, pain, all the cycles, and be in a blissful state, then you have to focus on something beyond everything. So how to maintain concentration to achieve there is through recognizing that energy, the unlimited consciousness. ओम का पहला स्वर व्यापक स्वर शक्तिमान स्वर अंतर्यामी यजन्मानंद मन निर्विकार दयालु सच्चिदानंद स्वरूप नित्य पवित्र ओमनिप्रेजेंट ओमनिशेंट ओमनिपोटेंट ऑल माइटी नो द्रिप आकाश आयु अग्नि जल पृथ्वी हर काल हर समय हर जगह हर मोड़ हर स्थिति में 24 गुण 33 कोटिया बार 5 क्रिया फ्रॉम इटर्निटी दैट ओमनीप्रेजेंट ओमनीशियंट ओमनीपोटेंट एनर्जी दैट रन्स दैट यूनिवर्स फ्रॉम 2 trillion गैलेक्सी विदिन आवर Milky Way, and there are parallel universes. From eternity, they keep showering your blessings on all of us. All desires of living beings are always fulfilled by you. Whatever is good and beneficial for us, you've provided us without asking. Ultimate peace and delight lies in your existence of sleep, contentment, everlasting joy, and happiness. And all expected things are attained in the soothing shade of feet and shelter of this eternal energy. आप अनंत काल से अपने उपकारों अपनी आशीर्वादों की वर्षा करते हो प्राणी मात्र की संपूर्ण कामनाओं को आप उत्तीर्ण पूर्ण करते हो हमारे लिए जो कुछ शुभ तथा हित करे उसे आप बिना मांगे स्वयं हमारे झोली में डालते जाते हो आपके आचरण में विचल शांति आनंद का वास है आपकी चरण शरण की शीतल छाया में परम तृप्ति है शाश्वत सुख की उपलब्धि सब अभिलषित पदार्थों की प्राप्ति है हमें सच्ची श्रद्धा तथा विश्वास हो हम स्तुति प्रार्थना उपासना करें कमल फूल की तरह रहे लाइक अ लोटस फ्लावर लिविंग इन दिस मटेरियल वर्ल्ड बट बियॉन्ड एंड आउट ऑफ इट यू डोंट हैव टू फाइट यू डोंट हैव टू हैव अ वॉर बट बी अ ह्यूमन इनफ टू बी अबव एंड बियॉन्ड लाइक अ यू नो लाइक अ लोटस फ्लावर कमल की फूल की तरह रिमूव द नैरो माइंडेडनेस सेल्फिशनेस एंगर जेलसी हेट्रेड वायलेंस इल विल नेगेटिविटीज ऑफ योर लाइफ एंड यू फाइंड the life becomes completely, truly living and free. You know, the amount of sickness that people get by all these behaviors is so sad. Ooh. का दूसरा सर्व रक्षक आदि दैविक आदि भौतिक आध्यात्मिक पृथ्वी लोग वनस्पति देव लोग हल्का हर काल हर समय हर जगह ये घर ये रास्ता ये काम ये दुनिया ये सृष्टि सब कुछ कैसे चलती ऑल इन परफेक्शन दिस नथिंग एक्चुअली रैंडमनेस एंड कोइंसिडेंस एवरीथिंग इज सिंक्रोनिसिटी एवरीथिंग हैज अ मीनिंग when you get deeply connected you understand there's meaning to everything everywhere you know how birds fly in such a beautiful synchronized manner everything in life is like that the more as you become your consciousness develops your relationship and your link is develops and everywhere there's peace and happiness be it plant kingdom animal kingdom or human kingdom everywhere you'll find that that sheep that protection wherever you are every time every moment it's nothing will be random there's no accidents going to happen You are always in the sheep then. Why not? Why aren't we actually trying to develop that? So that you yourself are in control rather than you bringing on every day, night, 360 degrees, every form of external gadgets to think you are protected. No, you're actually making a slave of yourself. You're prisoning yourself more than ever now. हमारे में सात्विक गुण की प्राप्ति और क्षमा सरलता स्थिरता निर्भरता अहंकार शून्यता तथा सब अच्छे गुण हमारे संपत्ति बने हमारा शरीर सूक्ष्म मन सूक्ष्म हो आत्मा पवित्र हो हमारी सारी इंद्रियां साफ हो जाए हृदय में दया तथा सहानुभूति हो वाणी में मिठास दृष्टि में प्यार हमें बुद्धि तथा विद्या की प्राप्ति हो हमारी व्यक्तित्व महान बने सो ट्राई एंड अक्वायर वर्चुअस क्वालिटीज ऑफ लिविंग फॉरगिवनेस सिंपलिसिटी स्टेबिलिटी फेयरलेसनेस हम्बलनेस मे योर बॉडी बी हेल्थ इन स्ट्रॉन्ग मन माइंड प्योर एंड एनलाइटेंड सोल डिवाइन एंड सुपर मे योर हार्ट हैव कंपैशन एंड सिंपैथी मे योर वर्ड्स बी अमीएबल एंड Have empathy, may we have vision of love, may we have complete education and wisdom. Dinath, dino ke mad mein vicharne wale Ishwar, aapke channan bindiyon mein hamara jeevan arpit ho. Ise apne seva mein lekar hame kirtaap kare Ishwar, hame kirtaap kare. Ka teesra That quality of this universal energy, primordial sound, that unlimited consciousness, unentangled quantum, is all pure, perfect, and complete. Shuddhamasi, Buddhamasi, Muktamasi, Niranjanamasi. May we acquire, or at least we, no effort is wasted in any lifetime. The earlier you start, the more you're likely to keep progressing, not in this life, but definitely for the next lifetime, because that component travels, never dies, as you know, travels through life forms. And with that, you are making a progress. As long as it is at a level of sattvic level, what you are doing, you will keep progressing. If you accumulate all the negative components, obviously, then your next phase will be not very good. Yeah? You might escape the justice system of humans, but as I said, the justice system of the creation of who you are truly, everyone is answerable. Ooh. Ooh. तत्त्वमसि अहम् ब्रह्म जयसिदन संकल्प मोक्ष शिव शक्ति रितम संकल्प करे साधना पुरुषार्थ अभ्यास विवेक तब वैराग्य की प्राप्ति होती है. डिस्क्रिमिनेटरी पावर डिटैचमेंट एंडेवर फॉर परफेक्शन. तब शरीर से जो तामसिक स्थिति है इनर्शिया नेगेटिवनेस लेजीनेस स्लोली विल गो अवे फ्रॉम योरसेल्फ विदाउट यू ड्रिंकिंग टन्स ऑफ कॉफी और टू मेक योरसेल्फ यू विल हैव द एनर्जी इटसेल्फ बिकॉज़ आई सेड द बॉडी इज द बेस्ट फार्मेसी. ओ योर माइंड व्हिच हैज दिस मिलियंस ऑफ मंकी थॉट्स डिस्टर्बिंग एग्जॉस्टिंग यू राजसिक स्थिति में भी गो एंड यू in a state of what's called nishkam karma, doing to your best of ability with the best of thoughts and intention without any expectation of rewards. That opens the door for the deepest aspect of who you are, the karan sharir. Then slowly it washes away the impressions that we were talking about for many, many lifetimes, which are inhibitory, but in this human form, and everybody has the opportunity, if you are to actually wash it off, the dust that is settled on it, and you can't even see that part of us. So the removal of these kleshas, therefore, avidya, asmita, raag, dvesha, avani dvesha, mrityu ka bhay, ulta jnan, lagao, badle ki bhavana, काम क्रोध जो मदा माया मत्सूर्य ईर्ष्या द्वेष वात पी का जो बैलेंस जरूरी है फॉर हेल्थी लिविंग व्हाट वी ईट व्हाट सीजन व्हाट टाइम जागृत स्वप्न सुषुप्ति तूर्य तूर्य तल भार्गव भार्गव चेतना शब्द वाणी संकल्प ध्यान ज्ञान अंजल अग्नि आकाश आशा स्मृति प्राण आत्मा परमात्मा. यू नो हाउ टू लिव विद इन अ सोसाइटी मैत्री भाव करुणा मुदिता उपेक्षा द शीट्स ऑफ दिस बॉडी दे आर फाइव अन्नमय कोश मनमय कोश प्राणमय कोश विज्ञानमय कोश आनंदमय कोश एंड अल्टीमेट सच्चिदानंद ब्लिसफुलनेस Lokeshna, Uteshna, Viteshna, these attachments slowly will go away. And you go through that eight stages of yoga. Ahimsa, Satya, Astya, Brahmacharya, Vigraha, Sausantos, Tapasya, Sohya, Ishwar, Purna. Then you acquire these stages that we move through. चित्र चित्र दो मुंह दो विचित्र दो एकाग्रह दो एकाग्रह की स्थिति योग चित्र वृत्ति निरोधा सर्विकल्प से सर्विचार सर्विच से निर्विच संप्रजा स्थिति से असंप्रजा स्थिति सर्गुण से निर्गुण सानत सुष्मिता कैवल्य की प्राप्ति समाधि धारणा ध्यान समाधि तो सिद्धि की प्राप्ति होती. यू फील स्लोली अनिमा महिमा गरिमा महिमा लरिमा महिमा प्रजापति प्राप्ति पकम्या इस्तिवा विस्तवा. मंत्र चिकित्सा ओम तप चक्षुर्देहितं पुरुषचाक्षु प्रतिमुचरत वशे में शरदा शतम जीवे में शरदा शतम शुनिया में शरदा शतम प्रभाम शरदा शतम दीन श्याम शरदा शतात वश्यम शरदा शतात यज्जाग्रतो दूर्मे दैवितिम दैवितम दूरमम ज्योतिषाम ज्योतिरीकम तन्मे मना शिव संकल्पमस्तु. ओम त्र्यंबकम यजामहे सुगंधिम पुष्पवर्धनम उर्वारुकमिव वंदनाम मूर्तिर्मुक्ष्मामृतात. ओम तेजोमसि तेजोमहि देहि ओम बलमसि बलमहि देहि ओजोमसि ओजोमहि देहि ओम वीरमसि वीरमहि देहि ओम मनुर्मसि मनुर्महि देहि ओम सहोमसि सहोमहि देहि ओम त्रिपाग्नेसि तन्वम्मे पाहि वृचोदाग्नेसि वृचो मे देहि ओम तनुमा तन्मम्मा भवतु मा ओम तमेव मा च तपिता तमेव बन्धुशिखा तमेव विद्याद्रविणं तमेव सर्वं मम देव देव ओम विश्वान्ति वसवितर्दुर्तानि पराशुवा यद्भद्रं तन्नाशुवा ओम हिरण्यगर्भा समवर्तताग्रे भूतस्य जातापति एक्याशु सदा धारि प्रतिबिम्ब ध्यामुते मा कृष्णे देवायाः दिशा विदेमा ओम आत्मदा बलदा यश विश्व पास्त प्रश्यम यश देवा यस्य छायामृतमेश मृते कृष्णे देवायाः दिशा विदेम ओम येन देवरुग्रा पृथ्वी च दिरा येन श्वास सवितम येन नाका योऽन्तरिक्षे राजशो विमाना कृष्णे देवायाः दिशा विदेम ओम प्रजापतिगत दीतानन्ने विश्वा जातानि परिता भगवा यत् कामास्ते जौ मस्तन्नो सुभयं श्यामगतरो रहिणाम ओम सन्नुबन्ध्रजनिता सभिदाता धमानि वेद भुवनानि विश्वा यत्र देवामृतमानुषान्ना शचित्रिये धामन्न धैर्यन्ता ओम अग्नेन सुपतारायस्मान् विश्वानि देवो युनानि विद्वान् यदस्मज्जौरान् मेनो भूयिशान्ति नमाप्तिं विधेम भूमियामी धाम देवगना पुत्रस्तु पास्ति तया मामद्मे दयाग्नि मीलाभिनम कुरु ओम नमो शंभवाय च नमो भवाय च नमः शंकराय च मस्कराय च नमः शिवाय च शिवतराय च ओम शन्नो मित्रा शन्नो वरुणा शन्नो भर्गो हरिमा शन्नो इंद्रो बृहस्पति शन्नो विष्णु रुक्रमा नमो वंदे नमस्तवाय तमुपदीक्षम ब्रह्मादि स्वस्तिर्भवतु सर्वेषां शान्तिर्भवतु सर्वेषां पूर्णं भवतु सर्वेषां मंगलं भवतु ओम स्वस्तिना इंद्रो बृहद्देवाशा स्वस्तिना पूषा विश्ववेदा स्वस्ति निष्ठाशर्यो वैष्णवेमी स्वस्तिना बृहस्पतिर्दधातुना ओम सहनावतु सहनाभुनक्तु सवीर्यं करवावहि तेजस्विनावधीतमस्तु मा विद्वेषां वहि ॐ देना तक्तेना भुजिन्ता ॐ यथा पिण्डे तथा ब्रह्माण्डे तथा ब्रह्माण्डे यथा पिण्डे ॐ कुर्णविवाहि कर्माणि जिजे विषेतां समायो त्वेति नान्यतिथि अस्ति न कर्मलिपते नवे ॐ अस्तु मा सत्गमया तमसो मा ज्योतिर्गमया मृत्युमा अमृतम गमया ओम सर्वे भवन्तु सुखिना सर्वे सन्तु निरामया सर्वे भद्राणि पश्यन्तु मा कश्चित् दुःखभावेतु मा कश्चित् दुःखभावेतु ओम पूर्णमदः पूर्णमिदं पूर्णात् पूर्णमुदच्यते पूर्णस्य पूर्णमादाय पूर्णमिवावशिष्यते 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 ओम देव शांति अंतरिक्ष गुम शांति पृथ्वी शांति रापा शांति रोषदय शांति वनस्पति शांति विश्व देवा शांति ब्रह्म शांति सर्वगुम शांति शांतिरेव शांति क्षमा शांतिरिधि ओम शांति 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 ओम सो कीप योर आईज क्लोज ट्राई एंड डू ब्राह्मणी सो कीप योर आईज टू फिंगर्स ऑन द आईलिड्स द थंब ऑन योर ट्रिगर्स क्लोज योर ईयर्स And do the hum sound. Mm-hmm. ओम शांति शांति शांति। परमात्मा की कृपा बना रहे जी। धन्यवाद भैया, कैसे हो? ठीक हो? कैसे चले? ठीक।